Thank you very much, Ghalib, and thank the Sharq Institute for a forum for bringing me back again. I've come back every meeting of theirs. I would like to focus upon two areas, but focus upon one area in particular. I served in Libya before and through and after the uprising, and Libya is still a mess. I served in Syria and I served in Lebanon. I want to concentrate on the future possible, a possibility of doing things in Bilad al-Sham. And really I want to, where the local population leads, others should follow. There cannot be one scenario for the region. Rather, the region's motor forces will face an increasingly confused set of extremes. It will be difficult for all countries, given their different makeups, fractured social settings, to be peaceful and prosperous. To provide simple outcomes, the analysis should focus on drivers, the forces that will propel change. The drivers must be able to identify economic growth, democracy, demographics, particularly youth demographics, the non-governmental sector. Conflict and conflict should not become the main driver. At the moment, conflict is the main driver in the region. The diaspora, and lastly, the external environment, importantly, the leadership in exile. Sketches that decisively promote politics are critical elements and determinants of whether regions' motor forces are enabled to drive change. Another determinant scenario is internal leadership. Excellent local leadership is the most basic necessary requirement for countries to succeed. A motor force scenario entails movement that allows the region to move ahead and take charge of the domestic, regional, and international levels with change. The local responsibility agenda is based upon the assumption that it will be more successful if the United Nations is perceived to be a facilitator, that is even-handed and exemplary. However, the region manages its refugees in a very, very important determinant. States need to be dynamic in order to drive the agendas that will attain peace based upon justice, equity, and importantly, major issues of land restoration and the definition of citizenship that needs to be addressed. Experience suggests that states cannot provide all of these ideas, much less have the motivation to drive the process. A dynamic civil society sector is important for creating an environment of peace, prosperity in the society, and requires innovation and will support the international community in their efforts. However, having said that, I've got 1 minute left.
Two minutes left.
Having said that, having served in Libya, and the night before five African presidents were in Mauritania about to go into Libya, the French decided that they were going to bomb that night. So it was clear that the international players, particularly the West, did not want a political outcome in Libya, but rather sought a military outcome. And the military outcome served their own agenda. It did not serve the agenda of the Libyans. It did not serve the agenda of the Africans. So we must indeed question what the guarantees are that is brought about by the Security Council. And of course, there is the right to protect. The right to protect was used in this instance to destroy a country. They did not leave the institutions intact. They destroyed a country that now has three governments. And having said that, I think I want to appeal to youth to get involved, to look at scenarios, to look at different scenarios, and that the scenario should be that is driven by the local people, because the local people are dying, the local people understand their problems, the local people understand what the solutions are and should be involved in the conclusion to that. So in the next 10 years, of course, it's going to be very difficult, but youth, and of course, as I said earlier, I was born before computers, and I was a bit taken aback this morning by Bitcoin and a country called Liberland. Thank you very much.
Well, thank you very much as well, too.